In this lesson, let's start to learn about joins. Thus far, we've worked with single tables. However, most of our real-world plans are going to have joins in them. So let's introduce those joins into our mix. SQL Server uses three operators to implement logical joins: the nested loop, the merge, and the hash. It's important to understand that no join algorithm is better than the others, and that the query optimizer will select the best join algorithm for the problem that it's facing. The input shown at the top in a nested loop join plan is known as the outer input, and the one at the bottom is the inner input. The algorithm for a nested loop join is very simple. The operator used to access the outer input is executed only once, and the operator used to access the inner input is executed once for every single record that qualifies for that outer input. We can see this in the tooltip of the cluster and index scan in the outer input, where the total number of estimated number of executions is 1. We can also see that there are 17 executions for the estimated number of rows on our cluster index seek. Now let's add another predicate called the territory ID that will give us more targeted results. Note that the outer input is again salesperson, the salesperson table. But this time it's not using an index. The new predicate is using the territory ID column, which is not included in any index. The query optimizer decides to use a cluster index scan instead. The filter on the salesperson table is asking for a territory ID equal to 1, and only 3 records qualify this time. As a result of that, the cluster index seek, which is the operator on the inner input, is executed 3 times.